Aircraft have come a very long way since they were introduced in the early 1900s. From their design, their functionality, and their usage, and of course the speed that they travel at. In this episode of FTD Facts, I'm going to be taking a look at the fastest aircraft that were ever made. Hey, what's happening all you beautiful people? This is Leroy Kenton here, and yeah, I'm just going to jump right into this list. And you guys already know what to do. Hit that like button if you love learning, and if you're a new face here to FTD Facts, just go ahead and press that subscribe button. As well as that bell notification, because you don't want to miss any of these episodes, like not even one. Okay, so let's just get into it, starting off at number 10, going down to number 1. First up, we have the F-111 Aardvark. This is a tactical bomber that was capable of flying at Mach 2.5. The F-111 is the first production airplane with a variable sweep wing, which is a wing configuration that can be changed in mid-flight. It was really cool when it was introduced. Now, the wing provided great aerodynamic efficiency. With the wings fully extended, the F-111 could take off and land as low as 2,000 feet. The F-111 also set a record for the longest low-level supersonic flight. It flew 172 miles at less than 1,000 feet of altitude. Now, that is extremely low. And that record was set on November 9th, 1966. On top of that, it also was the first tactical aircraft to cross the Atlantic from the United States to Europe without refueling, and that happened in May of 1967. Okay, so next up at number 9, we have the F-15 Eagle. So the F-15 has been claimed to be one of the most successful aircraft that has ever been built, and it's actually still in service. You know, the United States Air Force still uses them. Now, this aircraft is an American twin-engine all-weather tactical fighter aircraft. The F-15 is able to maneuver like it does because of the low wing load, which is the weight to wing area ratio with a high thrust to weight ratio, and this enables the aircraft to turn tightly without losing any airspeed. The F-15 can climb to 30,000 feet, which is approximately 9,100 meters, in just under 60 seconds or around there. Now, at certain speeds, the dynamic thrust output of the dual engine is greater than the aircraft's combat weight and drag. So it has the ability to accelerate vertically, and the F-15 can travel to more than 2.5 times the speed of sound. Now I'm gonna look at the MiG-31. So the Mikoyan MiG-31 is a supersonic interceptor aircraft. The MiG-31 is a twin-engine aircraft with a top speed of Mach 2.83. And if you're not familiar with the term Mach 2.8 or 2.5 or whatever, Mach means that it has broken the sound barrier. So just to give you an example, in this case, the MiG-31 travels at Mach 2.83. That means it travels 2.83 times the speed of sound. The production of the MiG-31s ended back in 1994. And you see, the MiG-31 was able to fly at supersonic speeds at both high and low altitudes. And it's also able to carry out long-range reception, precision strike, and defense suppression missions effectively. Moving on now to number 7, we have the XB-70 Valkyrie. So the XB-70 Valkyrie was a unique aircraft with 6 engines total. It was designed back in the late 50s by North American Aviation, and the Valkyrie was capable of getting to top speeds of Mach 3 and a little bit over that. The Valkyrie introduced new technologies, including a design that relied on an aerodynamic theory called the compression lift. So this is how it worked, okay? So at supersonic speeds, the fuselage of the B-70 would create a shockwave, right? So then the inlet wedge at the front of the delta wings would create a disturbance in the shockwave. And this would cause it to slow and build pressure under the wings. And this generated up to 40 pounds per square foot of additional lift at Mach 3. To increase directional stability as well as cruise efficiency and to hold the shockwave, a third of the wing could fold down as much as 65 degrees. In at number 6, we have the Bell X-2 Starbuster. So the Starbuster was an American research aircraft which had its first flight in the year 1955, and then a year later, in 1956, it was retired. So the X-2 was a rocket-powered swept-wing research aircraft. It was able to hit a speed of Mach 3.196 in the year 1956. However, soon after the speed was attained, the pilot, Milbert G. Apt, made a sharp turn and the aircraft tumbled out of control. So after that, they halted the project. Now, before I continue, I gotta let you know that there's actually a playlist here on FTD Facts that we created where you can watch more videos like this if you wanna learn more about fighter jets and other aircraft, or just facts about the military in general. We've talked about the F-16, you know, the MiG-29, as well as we've featured the top fighter jets and a whole lot more. So I'll have the link down below in the video description to that playlist. And I'll also link to it at the end screen of this episode, and I'll have it in the card section as well, so you can keep on learning after you finish up this episode. So I just wanted to let you know that, and we're halfway in this list now. And next up, we have the MiG-25. So the Mikoyan MiG-25 Fox Bat was a Soviet jet built to intercept American aircraft during the Cold War era. So the Fox Bat featured 4 air-to-air missiles, which made it an interceptor rather than a reconnaissance aircraft. It was capable of reaching Mach 3.2, although that would risk doing some major damage to its engine. Production of the MiG-25 was ended in the year 1984 after 1,186 of these aircrafts were made. The MiG-25 was one of the fastest serially produced interceptor aircraft and the second fastest serial produced aircraft that was ever made. All right, we're coming real close to the bottom of this list, and the next aircraft I want to feature is the YF-12. So the YF-12 was an experimental fighter interceptor version of the Lockheed A-12, which was a reconnaissance aircraft. In some flight tests that were done in the Air Force on May 1st, 1965, the YF-12 set a speed record of Mach 3.2 when it was used to fire 7 AIM-47 missiles. After retirement, it served as a research aircraft for NASA, which used it to develop several sufficient improvements in control for supersonic aircraft, including the SR-71, which is actually coming up next in this episode. So let's look at the SR-71 Blackbird. This is one of the most popular supersonic aircraft. This was capable of hitting speeds of over Mach 3.2. The Lockheed SR-71 was the fastest air-breathing manned aircraft to ever see operational service. Now, there wasn't a lot of these that were made. There was only 32 of them that were built, and its dark color was obviously behind the nickname Blackbird. The Blackbirds that were built all used reconnaissance and experimental research. The SR-71 costs as much as $200,000 per hour to operate. Pretty expensive, so that wasn't really sustainable. Okay, so we saw some fast aircraft, but in at number 2, we have the X-15. Now the speed just really jumped up. So the North American X-15, you know, this aircraft has a current world record for the fastest manned aircraft. Its maximum speed was Mach 6.70, and this was attained on October 3rd, 1967. The X-5 used rocket thrusters to steer it. Now, this made it possible to reach altitudes higher than 100 kilometers, which was also one of its world records. Now, there are 3 records that the X-15 set, and they were, you know, it was the first operational space plane, it got to heights of more than 100 kilometers, and it flew more than 6 times the speed of sound. Like I said, Mach 6.70. But you think that was super fast? It was nothing compared to the X-43, and this comes at number 1. So the X-43 is the fastest aircraft on record, and it got to top speeds of Mach 9.6. It was part of NASA's HyperX program, and it also used an experimental engine called the scramjet, in which the supersonic speeds of the vehicle itself compresses the air that the vehicle's engine in turn uses to generate hypersonic, which means faster than Mach 5, flight. And in addition to all of that, this aircraft would virtually surf on the supersonic shockwave that it created. During testing, it reached Mach 9.6, as I mentioned, and that was hit in November of 2004. Okay, so those were some pretty amazing aircraft, and you know, this really got me excited because some of these I have never heard of in my life. So now I want to examine them in more detail and just maybe bring you some specific videos that look at these aircraft with a lot more information. Anyways, guys, that's all the info I have about these aircrafts. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in another episode. I'm about to go fly out of here. Yeah. Okay, I'm not good at these puns. All right, bye, guys. Whatever, I don't care. Stop judging me. Hey, so if you're still watching, that means you definitely want to watch more FTD Facts episodes. Here's a playlist with more videos like this. There's tons of episodes there to keep you busy, so have fun, keep on learning, and tune into FTD Facts daily for more videos.